It's your choice now. What do you want to do?
Hey, they cry. But you promised me you will not do it. Promise.
Let your mind be renewed. That's why the Bible says we must have the mind of Christ. When you have the mind of Christ, you have the thought of Christ. You think like this or that thing. You say, as you think, so you are. Something positive, something great. You have to review your association. When you belong to the association of those who are just always negative. I want to buy a house. I want to start a business. How much do you have?
5,000. Oh. 5,000 can start a business?
Oh. Where have you some money to eat? Those are wrong associations. And a good association say, yes, you can try. Try. Something will happen on the way. Try. Anyone that is not embracing your vision is your enemy. I am accountable. Another sign for you looking for spouses or something. Anyone that does not celebrate your vision
is not going to even tolerate your vision.
You will know that's no go there. Whenever you say, I have A's in school now, I have this, as and then that's the Oh, I just got this promotion. I just got this letter. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's the sign. No, surely you can't go to anywhere with this person. Therefore, you say, oh, praise God. No, you got A. Oh, that's good. That's my prayer. I would say two cannot work together unless they agree together. Yes. When two of you is not in agreement, a house that divided against is taken apart. That is what is causing problem in homes now. When the husband is making it, the wife is jealous. Now you are becoming a millionaire. Maybe you are going to find another person outside now. When both of us just grow together. I think you are getting something there. Let's read Romans 12:2. Don't copy the behavior and custom of this world. Hello. You youth, copy, sagging. The latest. What is the latest? Youth, tell me. What is the latest? What's going on? The latest dressing code. Say, don't copy. Don't what?
Don't copy.
It's part of copy that you put earring. Boys, put in earring. It's part of it. You see what is what 50 Cent is doing. You see 50 Cent of that's what you do, you are copying. Because someone put three shirts together, gray, red, blue, and one is blue. You know what I'm saying? Nah, you see, don't copy anything that is in the world. Hallelujah. Don't copy. In this code, you see some people putting their pants here, uh-huh. And they'll be doing that. Don't you think it's madness? Yes. You do say hallelujah. And then here, praise God. It's in this code, when everybody is giving every part of the body warm, and some is and now no, something is missing. Okay, are you all here? Let's all read it.
Okay.
All you guys, you want to impress your boyfriend, and you now put your pants here with a big bag, and you put one here, and your tattoo is so open now, and you're not doing like this. When you see someone that is responsible, well dressed, it's going to drop you. Or anyone that say, I love you. Then you go to bed with them. They will now look for someone that have never tasted their happy. And those are the ones that will marry. It's normal. How can you put someone? You don't know whether it's the same way she has allowed you in, the same way she has been allowed other people in. So you cannot have confidence in that type of a lady. And you know men, you guys, men are always looking. Anything they struggle to get, that's what they cherish. They struggle. And you cannot come to my house. Is it the parents at all? Sweet. I will make sure I get it. I will make sure God, because of that, he can even be going to the church. And he said, God, touch the parents.
Hallelujah.
We must put on the character of Christ by developing new godly habits. Emily, your character is essentially the sum of your habits. It is how you habitually act. How some people habitually, they are liars. They don't need to think before they tell lies. Say, Pastor, anything you need, I'm going to supply to the church. He doesn't have a debt to supply. It's not that. If he has the money, he's not even going to supply. They just want, you know, some people that will tell you anything that will make you happy. Are you being there?
Yes.
Anything just to make you feel good. Don't, please don't rely on it. They can ask to come tomorrow and get the check of $5,000. When you get there tomorrow, when did I say that? You know that you don't say anything that comes to their mouth just to make you feel good. It's not that they want to do it. You know, whom are you going to prefer? Someone that said, I'm not going to do this. It's in the Bible. And someone that said, I'm going to do it. And he did not do it. But the one that said, he's not going to do it. And he ended up doing it. The Bible says, put on a new self to be like God in true righteousness. We need to be what? Like God in true righteousness. We need to be like God in what?
In true righteousness.
Let's go to Ephesians 2. Ephesians 4. I will read 22 to 23 first. Throw out your old sinful nation and your former way of life. Can you see? Your former, before you get your life to Jesus Christ, if this is a Bible study, I would have asked you a question. What is different between you now and before you get your life to Jesus Christ? If you still carry out all those behavior, nothing changes. You are not in Christ. Because Christ has to take something away from you. Hello? Christ has to transform you. Christ has to reshape you. All sinful nature and your former way of life, which is corrupted by lust and deception. Instead, let the Spirit renew your thoughts and attitude. Let the Spirit what? Before you give your life to Jesus, you're always moody. Joy. Where is love? Where is peace? Where is kindness? You are always touching. You cannot even control your tongue. Things must be different. You must be able to say, before you are sensitive, now you are not. Before you are easily angered, now. Before your word, any word that comes out of your mouth is as big as this. Like a bomb. You just said,